If you're struggling with factoring quadratic trinomials like this, where the leading coefficient here is not equal to 1, then this video is for you, because I'll show you 5 different ways to do it. The first way is called the AC method with grouping. This is the A, this is the C. We first multiply A and C together. 6 times negative 3, we get negative 18. Then, we have to think about two numbers that they multiply to negative 18. And when we add them, we get positive 7. And the correct combination is 9 and negative 2. But if one of the numbers is negative, write it down first. So I'll put down negative 2 and 9. We do multiply, get negative 18. And when we add them, we do get 7. And this will allow us to do the following. We keep the 6x squared, but for the 7x, we will break it down as negative 2x plus 9x. This is still 7x. And then, of course, at the end, we still have the minus 3. Now we have 4 terms. We can do this by grouping. The first 2 and then the last 2. 6 and 2, we can factor out 2. X squared and x, we can factor on x. 6 divided by 2, we get 3. X squared divided by x, we get x to the first. Minus 2 divided by 2 is minus 1, and the x is out already, so that's what we have. Then put down the plus. 9 and 3, we can factor out 3. 9 divided by 3 is 3, and then x is still right here. Negative 3 divided by 3 is minus 1. Now, as we can see, this and that are the same. We can factor that out, and then we have 3x minus 1. Just put it down one time. Yeah, we took it out. And the second factor is this and that. So 2x plus 3. And we're done. For the second method, it's pretty much the same thing. It's called the AC method with the box. We still do A times C and get negative 18, and we still need negative 2 and 9 to get 7. And now we are going to first draw a box like this, and then we are going to cut it like this. For this right here, go ahead and put down 6x squared. For this right here, go ahead and write that down, minus 2x, and then also the 9x. This and that gives us the 7x. Lastly, we have that minus 3. Now, just look at the top row, 6 and 2, we can factor out a 2. X squared and x, we can factor out an x. Done with that. Now, bottom row, 9 and 3, we can factor out 3. This has x, this does not, so can I factor out the x? And in fact, we took out a positive 3, right? So plus. Now, do the first column, 6 and 9, we can factor out 3. X squared and x, we can factor out an x. Here, minus 2x minus 3, we can factor out a minus 1. So the answer is just this right here, 3x minus 1, and then the other one, 2x plus 3. Of course, if you switch the order of the factors, doesn't matter. That's it. Now for the third method, it gets a little bit weird. We still need to do A times C and get negative 18, and we still need negative 2 and 9 to get the 7. Check this out, let me just proceed. Instead of do this by grouping, we'll draw the box. We first just draw two sets of parentheses. And then you see here we have 6x squared, right? Just go ahead and write down 6x and 6x. Trust me, it works. And then let's go ahead and enter minus 2 and then plus 9. All right, now what though? Notice I didn't put an equal sign, because this is not equal to this. But check this out. Here we have 6x and 2. 6 and 2, we can divide by 2. We can reduce that by 2. And then we will get 3x minus 1, first factor. 6 and 9, we can have a common factor 3. We can divide this by 3, likewise do the same thing. Divided by the common factor, and then this right here we get 2x, and then right here we get plus 3. I can tell you this is equal to that. And then we're done. This is just like an intermediate step. Now for the next way, you might be thinking it doesn't make sense either, but let me tell you, it also works. This right here is called the slide and divide. I also call this the Amazon Prime way because you do this. Again, it's a times c once again, right? But anyway though, you just go ahead and put a 6 multiply with the negative 3, and then you will have x squared plus 7x and then minus 18. Again, this is not the same as that, but just trust me, at the end, we will get the correct factoring. Now what though? Well, this is so much easier to factor, right? It's just a coefficient 1 here, so it's just x and x. And what do we need? We need minus 2 and positive 9 in order to get what? Negative 18, and then when we add them, we get 7. Now what? Check this out. If you do it this way, then what you want to do is divide this by 6 because we didn't use it. Divide it by 6, and then divide this number by 6 as well. 2 over 6, can we reduce that? Yes. If we reduce that, we get 1/3, isn't it? But we still have the 3. We are going to put a 3 here. Let's try this. 9 over 6, right? Reduce that by 3, we get 3 over 2. And then we have a denominator, so put a 2 right here. And I'll tell you this right here. Just ignore the middle now, because I can tell you the answer is 3x minus 1 times 2x plus 3. And then we are done. And this is equal to that. Done. And now for the last way, I think it's the most straightforward way. And that's also the method I use for teaching my students. I call this the tic-tac-toe method. What we want to do first is just draw the tic-tac-toe boxes like this. And then you are going to ask yourself, what times 4 will give us 6x squared? And the correct combination is 2x and 3x. Now, move here. And then you have to ask yourself, what times 4 will give you negative 3? Well, you can have negative 1 and 3, or maybe 3 here and negative 1, right? I don't know. Let's just go ahead and put down negative 1 here and 3 here. I have no idea. Then, this is the check. You take this times that, you put it here, 6x. And then you take this, multiply by that, you get negative 3x. 6x minus 3x, do we get 7x? No. In that case, that means we didn't get the correct combination. So what that means is, don't worry, just try again. The correct combination for this is, we put a 3 here and negative 1 here. 2x times negative 1, we get negative 2x. 3 times 3x is 9x. Together, we do get a positive 7x. Now, when we write down the answer, we read it across. 2x plus 3 times 3x minus 1. Just like this. Let me know which way you like the most.